Hello there, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Today we're going to be playing Tales of Azaria. Oh yeah. This is the most edgy Tales of game ever. Which makes it the most entertaining, obviously. Damn, being the most entertaining Tales of game is definitely pretty good. I am looking for the Tales of Arise when it comes out. I think I pre-ordered it a long time ago. Whew. It's trying to block me, but I don't care because I'm in. Alright, let's skip the opening because it's copyright AF. Even though it's pretty cool. There's Velvet Crow. Look at all those belts on her. Yeah, her clothing is in tatters. Sure like her soul ever since her brother died. Sure like my soul. Yeah. It's only held together by belts. Which makes it the best. I mean, Velvet's costume, not my, I knew this would be bad. Hey look, I got Spirit Core Crystal. I know what that is, that's from Tales of Hearts R. Speaking of which, I have Tales of Heart for the PS Vita. I could play that. Sure, I could play that.
Scout ship settings.
I could definitely play that after maybe playing this. Just a chip copper coin down here. Excuse me. Sorry, I just ate up not too long ago.
Sir, we just received a Sylph-Jay from the boss of the Bloodwings. She has a job for us and wants us to meet her in Logris. How should we respond?
Let's do it. Besides, we need to see if that demon in the villa was actually a Therian.
Good point. And the Bloodwings might know something about the other Therians too.
Okay, let's go get him.
For Logris. Prepare to set sail. Ready anytime.
Oh, I'm glad our illegal underworld connections are allowing us to get places that we need to go. Thank you, illegal underworld connections.
I lost my mother to a demon. Yet that girl's a Therian. I don't even know what I want anymore.
Eleanor's having a crisis of faith.
Hey, that's pretty. You like to look at that thing, don't you?
Oh, yes.
Yes. My mother... Someone very important to me gave me this. I treasure it a lot. Looking at it gives me strength. Do you want to see it?
Yeah! Ah!
What's wrong?
My face! It's scary!
Oh, you're a Therian.
I don't want to look like that! I don't want my mommy to hate me! Mommy! Mommy!
Yeah, she's a little whiny, but that's okay.
When I was her age,
I understand how she feels.
That's just how I cried.
Come on, Eleanor, cheer her up.
Come on, Anna. I want you to see this.
That huge owie. What happened?
Wait, what? He's undressing.
It's big and ugly, isn't it? There are scary things about my body, too. But do you think I'm scary, Kamalana?
No.
No, not at all. But are you all right? Does that hurt?
Thanks, sweetie. I'm all right. I promise.
Oh.
What about me? Do you think I'm scary?
No.
You're such a sweetheart, Kamalana. Nobody could ever be scared of you. Not me. Not your mother. Not Lafayette. You don't have to cry anymore. It'll be okay. I promise.
Oh, are we gonna tell her the truth about her mother one day?
That scar. Was it from a demon?
Yeah. They attacked my village when I was a girl. I was so hurt, I couldn't move. But my mother lured them away from me so I could survive.
What happened to her?
The last thing she said to me was, "Stay strong and keep living."
Oh.
She's gone.
Come to the deck. Grimoire says she's learned something from the book.
Okay, we'll come to the deck.
Hey, why is your face so red?
It's nothing.
I just showed him my body.
Somehow I doubt that.
It's nothing, I swear.
It's not like I saw things on her body. No, I mean, no. We didn't see that, no.
Do you all remember the second verse of that song Lafayette read earlier?
Four Empyreans may tear him asunder, but so long as there is one receptive to divine power, Therian shall be forever reborn in sight of the full crimson moon.
Right. That's what I've gathered you all here to discuss. And we think that passage means that Enominat and the Therians will be revived by a chosen one, right? Yes, but the shall be forever reborn part kept bothering me. I've reconsidered my analysis. Suppose that instead of someone being chosen by Enominat to create Therians, the song means that Enominat chooses who becomes Therians. But so long as there is one receptive to divine power, Therians shall be forever reborn. What do you think that could mean? That someone receptive to Enominat's power will be reborn as a Therian.
Like Kamoana.
Which is to say that the Abbey figured out how to turn people into Therians and then got right to work.
Oh yeah, they did mention that.
Are you really that surprised? Artorias has always been one to prioritize the many over the individual, as I well know. Another thing to consider is this wording about Therians being forever reborn. This could mean that one Therian will be reborn again and again. Or it could mean that different Therians will be born to take their place. Meaning that even if you kill one, there are more waiting in line. They can't be wiped out.
Looks like prioritizing the one over the many was the right call this time, eh, Velvet?
I never said I wouldn't kill her, if it would prevent Enominat's reawakening. But Therians can't be killed. Not truly.
So, in a nutshell, if you kill one, another person who's receptive to Enominat's power will be reborn as one.
Right. But the song says that seven mouths feed the body. So there's only so many around.
If you don't kill them, the next ones won't be born.
Exactly. So we remove the seven Therians from their Earth Pulse points instead. But then, we also have to protect them so the Abbey doesn't steal them back. Or kill them.
Sounds tricky. We've got to protect my bug, too.
Yeah, you take real good care of that thing now. Got it?
Okay.
You bet I will.
Because that bug is a Therian, too.
We should probably work on securing a proper hideout for ourselves. You got a secret base or anything, Aizen?
It's every man's fantasy, but sadly, I don't.
We need a hard-to-find spot. One where we can guarantee a steady supply of malevolence for the Therians.
A prison.
Somewhere devoid of people, but full of malevolence. Real poser you got there.
With the Abbey in control of the entire continent, finding a place like that will be easier said than done.
Meanwhile, Enominat's reawakening draws ever closer. We'll have to keep collecting our Therians while we search for...
Are you sure this is what we should be doing?
Let's just get to Logris.
I mean, we removed one and it kind of caused some bad things to happen. But if that means getting all of them out of there means something really bad will happen. Yeah, I don't know about this plan. Also, I played the game before, I totally know.
Hey, old man! Give me all the water and food you got! Wait your turn, moron! I was drifting out at sea for 3 days! Almost died out there! Weh-heh, poor you! You probably deserved it! Say that again, wise ass! I dare ya!
Ah, shut up, both of ya! No one's getting anything until you pay me what you owe first.
Are they gonna be okay?
Let's leave him alone, Nate.
Sailors are just a short-tempered bunch, that's all.
Huh? The hell are you doing?
What's going on?
They've jacked up the price to dock our ship here.
Oh yeah? Some real balls you've got there, buddy.
If you lot want to moor here, that's the price you're gonna pay. Look, pirates are a liability to begin with, but calling your crew infamous these days would be putting it lightly.
Wait, what do you mean?
The more wanted you are, the more it's gonna cost to hide you. Capiche?
Hard to argue there. Benwick, just pay the man what he wants.
Yes, sir. You're such pushovers. You and the captain both.
I knew I could count on you to come through, Aizen. Pleasure doing business with you.
Thank you for the money, dummy. Ack, 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 snorts.
Looks like I'm causing you trouble.
It comes with the job. Don't sweat it. Some sailors just have longer tempers than others.
Yes, like me.
Noted.
Alright, now that we're done with the beach area, we gotta change out of our swimsuits. Alright, let's change into something even more silly. Ooh, I like that outfit. Yes. And Aizen, you should have on a pirate outfit. Yes. There you go. Let's get you something a little better. Alright, I guess we'll dress her in that. Let's dress him up as a, Yakuza, yeah. Like that. Alright, where are your outfits? Wow, that is one silly outfit. You know, this is the most ridiculous outfit of them all. Yes. I will go with that. Just cuz. I'd be wearing a pirate costume and got fishnets. The fishnets are very... Yes, we certainly aren't noticed. Yes, fishnets are very sexy. Of course. Right, let's go see what the Bloodlings want, huh? Man, I can't believe we're back in the capital. What about your mission to Melchior, Mr. Miss Eleanor?
Here we are, back in Logris. It was a lot tougher to get in the first time.
More funny than tough, if you ask me.
Oh, you mean Velvet's little dove act? Coo coo.
Please don't remind me of that.
I'd be teasing her if I were you. You know how she can get. Oh, don't act like you didn't enjoy it too. I'm sure you did, right? Good little boys don't lie to adults, you know.
I might have. Just a little.
Say it like a dove.
It was funny. Coo, coo.
Oh, wow. Yes, I don't have the humiliation fetish or anything, no. No. It's not like that, okay? Knock him out. Alright, let's get that silly outfit out. Now the enemies are stronger since the last time we were here, so we might as well fight them all.
That's the end for you!
What an easy victory! I am invincible!
Cool.
We can do this!
Take him down, Aizen. Perfect mayhem. Oh yeah. That was such a Chad move right there, man. Wreck him, wreck him, wreck him. There we go, took him down. We're not gaining much experience.
Not worth my time.
Devour them all. There we go, wreck them. I think the music might be being affected by Miss Eleanor's outfit.
We won, right? Right?
Oh well, I don't care. I don't care because it's entertaining. Alright, now let's wreck him. Although I might care if I get copyright claim for it.
Come on, really?
I might care if I get copyright claim for that. You know. Alright, as entertaining as this costume is. Yeah, I'm afraid we'll have to change it. Yes, that is the most sexy one. That is clearly the most superior choice of them all.
Not worth my time.
Is the music still going? I guess it might be the... It might be the school uniform, actually. Might be the school uniform. Okay, let's dress him up as a chef. Now, do we have a chef app to go with that? Not really, no. Hey, there it is. Hey, that doesn't look like a chef's hat. What's it? Why is it black? Chef's hats are not black. Alright, I guess we'll change it to that. I might as well kill the enemies for the grade bonus, at least.
I'll finish this now.
Knock him out. Actually, I'm not sure what costume it is, actually.
Well, that about does it.
Sounds pretty normal. I guess it's just a new theme. For being later in the game. Yeah, devour him. We're running out of HP. Sadly, the bad thing about the Therian arm is it does wreck your HP a lot. It's really powerful though. It lets you do a big special attack. At a cost. That cost being HP.
I'm extra good at beating up the weak ones.
They were nothing.
Agreed, Velvet. They were very weak. Unlike you. Of course, you have to be strong, Miss Velvet. You're fighting the world itself. You're fighting the world and all the unfairness of it. There we go. Put them all out. Alright, we need to go this way. Might as well fight more enemies for the grade bonus.
Now we
back him down. Knock them all out. There we go, got them all.
We won, right? Right.
They were nothing before us. Those guys were nothing. I don't have a grade bonus, but that's okay. I don't need to fight more enemies. They're not giving that much XP anyway. I think we're overleveled. I assume it's gonna be harder to get through here.
Man, the capital sure is big.
Yeah, with historical buildings and artisans and all, there's much of interest here for a boy who loves to learn.
Uh-huh.
Sightseeing's nice and all, but don't wander off and get lost.
Oh yeah, sorry.
Don't worry about him. He can take care of himself.
I know, I was just saying.
Alright, are you gonna turn him into Melchior? Alright, we should probably go see what the Bloodwings want. Let's just go right over there directly.
Eleanor, I need you to wait outside. The boss of the Bloodwings knows an exorcist is with us, but...
Say no more. I'm sure they have clients who wouldn't appreciate their faces being known to the Abbey.
Correct. Lafayette, you stay with Eleanor.
Okay.
I'll be back soon.
Are we sure that's a good idea?
My thanks for coming all this way. It's been a while. Would you care for a peach pie?
What do you want?
Oh, it would do you good to unwind every now and again, you know. Stretch a bow too far and its string is bound to snap.
What do you want?
Yes, just tell me what you want.
I would like you to escort this person out of the capital.
A mysterious rogue figure?
Something smells about this. Literally. Where am I taking them?
Somewhere the authorities can't reach them.
Sounds nice. I could do with such a place myself.
No joke. We've been looking for a place to lay low, but we haven't had any luck yet.
Well, come to think of it, I've heard a rumor that it's been a while since the Abbey has had any contact from Titania.
The prison island.
Where Velvet was.
But I thought the Abbey was in direct control of that place. Has the situation there gotten that bad since you left?
I guess since she was Aetherian.
The answer is right under your nose. I think it might work.
Yeah, could make a decent hideout, actually. The Therians could definitely get their fill of malevolence there.
And the Abbey is far too goody-goody to imagine an escaped prisoner would ever return to her prison by her own free will.
At the very least, I'd say it's worth checking out.
And we can check out the Earth Pulse Point there?
Intel has proven useful.
It has. But before we go, have you heard anything about the Abbey harboring demons?
I'm aware there was a demon in the villa, and that it has been relocated.
Relocated where?
I can't say right this moment, but I'm sure we will find out shortly.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Then in exchange for this passenger's safety, I want more information on that demon.
You've got a deal.
Very well.
Aizen, I heard about your confrontation with Melchior. I'm sorry I wasn't able to help you find him.
It's okay, we're gonna get him at the end of the game.
It's fine. What's done is done.
Have you given up on finding Ifrit?
No. No, we have not.
No. I haven't. The crew and I will do whatever we can to quash the Abbey's plans. We do them enough damage, and the Abbey ought to start thinking about putting their hostage to good use. They'll set him up as a trap for us, and that's when we'll steal him back.
Well, if you say so, Aizen.
Attacking the Abbey to create an opening for his escape.
Clever. It's what Ifrid would do. That's all.
All right, then we'll go with that plan. All right, Aizen, let's go with your plan. Eleanor, are you planning to take him back?
Yeah.
The Shepherd has a special mission for you.
Don't fall for it, you're being mind controlled.
To protect the Malak Lafiset and bring him to the Logris Abbey headquarters.
What's wrong?
Hey, you want to take a walk around the capital for a bit? I can show you some of the sights.
But,
You can't trust me. I understand.
No, it's not bad. I promise. I'd love to go sightseeing with you, Eleanor.
Oh.
Luffy said. Well, we'll do it another time, okay?
Why?
It's just... You know, Velvet would get mad at us.
Get mad about what?
Ah, you're done. And who is this?
A VIP entrusted to us by the head of the Bloodwings. We're stowing them away on Titania where the bad guys can't get at them.
The prison island? Just who is this person?
Didn't ask.
What?
That's none of our business.
Hey. Something smells nice.
Stop sniffing things. We're leaving.
Okay, let's go. Good, my expedition is back. Awesome. We only got Lizard Tail. Okay.
Scout ship.
I can't believe you take a job without bothering to ask who you're escorting or why.
The less you know, the less trouble you invite.
That's true. Besides, we in the underworld don't ask too many questions. That's a good way to lose your head. Or, you know, get killed. Yeah. But I'm sure the time will come when we'll be able to figure out who it is. I know who it is. I know who it is, by the way. But I'm not gonna tell you directly, no. That would be very irresponsible of me. Besides, I want it to be a surprise. You're not gonna believe it. It's gonna blow your mind. Maybe. Well, relatively speaking, it might. Then again, maybe it won't. Yeah, it's on a need-to-know basis, and we don't need to know. Hey, look, a shop. All these things kind of suck. At least we can enhance something. Which one do we do? Max HP, I think. Let's equip our new stuff. There we go. I guess we don't have a choice. We'll get more gear when we get when we fight more battles. Amber fragments, we don't need any of those. La-di-da-di-da, I'm just gonna leave and my pirate ship. Our pirates. Too bad there's not a... Wait, there is a spooky, scary skeleton ghost pirate in this game. I remember it quite well. Because it's redacted.
This is bullcrap. You're gouging us just because you can.
Well, if you want to pay less, maybe you should go find someone more generous, hmm?
Looks like they're at it again.
Wait, what's that? Something bad is happening.
Huh? What's happening? Benwick, snap out of it! Benwick!
They're losing their minds.
I was haggling for supplies, and...
Tell you what, I'll give you a fair price. Actually, just take what you need.
Wait, what? He changed his mind just
we
like that?
We shall endeavor to help contribute to the common good of humanity, rather than selfishly pursue wanton profit.
They're being mind controlled.
Are you sure?
No. Wait. What was I saying?
You're being mind controlled, dude. Illuminati's domain is growing.
Too, didn't you, kiddo?
Yeah. It disappeared, but I felt a strong force coming from somewhere to the north.
It's called a domain. A Moloch zone of influence.
That's Illuminati's influence.
Wait, if it's north of here, then...
The Empyrean's throne?
Did that happen because of something Innominat and Artorias did?
I don't know.
Did we investigate that, maybe?
Bad feeling about this. We should get far away from here, and quickly.
So, the suppression.
The suppression of free will, question mark? Because that's what it feels like. Yo, can I board the ship? Alright, let's go to the prison island. I'm sure something really wonderful will happen there.
Alright, we're safely on the rolling waves. Don't you think it's time you showed us your face, Mystery Monk? You're right. My apologies.
He's not a rogue at all.
I knew it! Prince Percival!
Wait, how did you know?
Percival Ilmid Asgard. Crowned prince and heir to the throne of the Midgand Kingdom.
But what's he doing here?
So he's next in line, is he?
It looks like someone already had me figured out.
Yes, Your Highness. I could tell from your fragrant wood scent, as only the royal family may wear it. But if I may ask, why?
Must I explain myself to gain your aid? I myself could ask what an exorcist is doing consorting with members of the underworld.
I don't...
It doesn't matter why you're here. On this ship, you're here for us to use to our advantage.
Treat me as you will. It's not like I can ever go back.
Why not?
For a fellow born with silver spoons spewing out of his mouth, Princey Pooh's rather laid back.
Prince Percival is an upstanding man, renowned for both his intelligence and his fair, just demeanor. It's widely believed that with him on the throne, Midgand's prosperity will continue and...
Look, I played dumb earlier, but I smelled that scent too. He wore it for us to notice. He wanted us to know just what sort of position he held, and how useful he could be to us.
He surprised me, at least.
Do you think we're being led into another trap?
We definitely can't take that possibility off the table.
When the time comes, he'll make a good hostage, if nothing else.
Not if the ones we face are after his life, too.
For now, let's just make sure we keep an eye on him.
The prince. He said he couldn't go back. I wonder why.
Something going on with the royal family that Arthorius has pretty much taken over command of? Question mark? Yes.
The whole island's a prison. It's like a secret fort or something.
Okay, I guess.
Weirdly quiet, though.
Yeah, I don't see a single exorcist on one.
Because they're all gone.
Let's scope out the inside.
Plus, we can find another Earth Pulse point here. Alright, let's go inside and check it out. That's an exorcist.
An exorcist.
Are you alright? Headless. Knights.
Headless knight, what?
She's dead. The headless knight is back?
Whoa! Oh, that's not a headless knight.
Think this is the demon that attacked her?
I don't think so.
Another prison riot?
Alright, let's riot again.
Kurogane, Dial. You two protect Kamoana and the prince.
Understood.
Don't worry, we can take this thing. It's just a normal enemy. We don't really need to be that worried about it. I mean, we're overleveled as it is. And Lafayette just killed it. Just Lafayette, such little Chad, man.
So did the Abbey actually fail to quell the riot?
I find that hard to believe. The prison was heavily staffed with exorcists.
Something did it.
Venomization.
Venomized.
Venomization.
A dark ritual, forcing demons to eat each other in order to produce ever stronger demons.
So the demons devoured each other, creating a demon too powerful for the exorcists to control?
I imagine the riot didn't help.
Now whose fault could that have been, I wonder?
See, I wonder who it could have been.
Whatever happened doesn't matter to us now. We need to focus on how to take this place for ourselves.
That exorcist from before said something about a headless knight, right?
Okay, let's look for a headless knight.
Probably the leader.
Then we hunt it down and destroy it.
All right.
Until we capture the island, let's use this room for our staging ground. I'll leave the prince and Kamoana to you two. Eliminate any enemies who come in.
Understood.
Don't expect much from me, but all right.
Kamoana, if anything happens, call for me and I'll come running to protect you, okay?
Okay. You stay safe too, Eleanor.
I think she would be fine for being a Therion, but nope. Don't worry. Not quite. I like the music here. It's edgy and dark. Just the way I like it. Yeah, that's the way to play the game. Being edgy and dark. All the time, yeah. Enemies. Flame Witch! Are they like writing little matches? Their flame mods or whatever? I like to imagine they're writing little matchsticks. Oh, that's probably not it. I just think that'd be a cool aesthetic, that's all. You don't need to know how the blade works. It works by pure edge. That's how you need to know.
We can do this.
Let's go. No
escape. These are some cute looking gargoyles. I mean, I'd like to have gargoyles at my church if they look like this. Or, I mean, not that I'm into that or anything, no. I can assure you I'm not. I was just making commentary, yeah. I got a trident out of it, cool. There's more enemies here.
We can do this.
Let's see, what type are they? Fiends? Fiend and demi-human. Do we have anything that works on those? Cerberus wave, huh? Down.
Come on, really?
What's this?
I'll finish this now.
All right, whatever it is, we got a favorable encounter. There, we took him down.
I did good.
Good, we took them all down. There's no herbs here. Let's go back. This place is clearly a dead end. We need to go the other way. Yeah. Listen to that edge. Ow, I'm cutting myself so deep on it. Yeah. Edge is what this game is all about. It's got a lot of edge. Some people may not like the edge, and that's okay. Yeah, some of you need to really embrace the edge. Yeah, edge is good for you, man. Edge is awesome.
Finish this now.
There we go, took them all down.
Is that supposed to be a joke?
Chloronic spear, cool.
This island reeks with malevolence.
I imagine it's emanating from all the big old demons roaming about.
Alright, stun, good. Good job on that binding order. And there we go with Velvets, just to flex. No, you're not allowed to go home. Now we got a new spear If only we had something to upgrade it. Yeah. What, you want to fight?
Not worth my time.
Take him down.
Water mine!
Camera, please. Alright, we're taking him down.
Hey, is everyone alright?
Good, we took them all down. Turtles, what are you doing here?
Hey.
I'm so busy I can't even notice what's going on around me.
You're not fooling anybody. Why bother?
I was hoping to not have to deal with yous guys. Whenever I run into yous, I always lose so much monies.
Because Velvet always forces unreasonable demands on you?
Oh, Miss Exorcist! Your concern warms my little turtle's heart.
I'm not forcing anything. I just think he's trying to take advantage of us by fixing his prices well above market rate.
Price fixing? As in deliberately marking up items so as to take advantage of the less fortunate? I was under the impression that the Abbey strictly forbade such unscrupulous business tactics.
Perish the thought, Miz. Our accounting is always above board. 25 hours a day, 8 days a week. No matter when's and no matter where's, you can get whatever you need for the same fair price.
That's good to hear. Eleanor, give the nice turtles that smile he so desires.
I'm sure running a business is hard work. Hang in there.
Much obliged.
Oh. Let us buy a few things. And equipped. All right, let's enhance some things. There is it. There we go, that should do. That should do quite nicely. Ooh, treasure, I'll take that. Don't mind if I do. Silver coins, I don't need any of that. I do wonder where the boss is. They're probably not over there.
From the way you were talking, it seemed like you had an idea of who was behind the riot. What happened here?
I'd think someone in your position would know.
There were reports of a large riot, but I was caught up in chasing you, so I heard little else.
It was a small affair, really. Velvet Rokuro and I were being held on this island. Velvet instigated the other prisoners to riot so that we could escape.
She used the prisoners?
Yeah. You'd expect different from me?
No.
How did it end?
We didn't stay to see, but the prisoners were losing badly. At least, that's what it looked like. But if that was the case, then where did all the exorcists...
Did they succumb to malevolence after she left?
...to report the incident, but the other guards should have remained at their posts.
Well, if they didn't flee,
We have to assume they were all killed.
By this headless knight, perhaps?
Maybe.
Well, no sense losing our heads, I suppose. But it looks like we're in for a heck of a fight.
All we have to do is mop up anyone who's left.
Alright, let's go take care of it then. I'm sure it'll be an easy job. What? You think this'll be tough? Nah. We're edgy. We can handle anything. Guess I could fight more monsters now. There doesn't appear to be anything important here. Maybe if I go this way. Where is the Headless Knight? It could be anywhere. Including all the way down below. Awfully dark and spooky down here. Who knows what we could find. Fight from a few more enemies. What's over here? There's our target right there.
The Headless Knight!
He must be the product of the venomization.
Well, he definitely looks vicious enough.
Not as vicious as our Velvet, though.
Let's fight. Don't I have hard second heaviest armored enemies? Alright, you stunned and knocked it. Oof, I'm getting beat up. I got stunned. Alright, we're taking him down. See, we're over level for this. Wow, that is a rainbow. Taking him out with the rainbow. Taste the rainbow. Taste the rainbow, motherfucker.
Yeah.
I feel something again.
More malevolence?
No, another Earth Pulse point. It must be on this island.
I sense it too. It's very close.
I already know where it is.
Directly underneath us, I would guess.
That's where I was being held prisoner. Thought I won that pretty easily.
What is this place?
Welcome to the most secure cell in the entire complex. The darkest hole in Titania. Feel anything, Lafayette?
Yeah, I think this is the Earth Pulse Point.
If this cell is where the Earth Pulse Point is, then does that mean it housed a Therian?
Yes, me.
Yeah, and a real hungry one at that. Every day, they would toss demons into its cell. It would devour its fill, then wipe the blood from its lips. Never once realizing, it was delivering to Enominat the malevolence of hundreds of demons and prisoners.
They were using her.
And then one day, there appeared before it a female Moloch, who shattered the barrier and freed the Therian from its cage. But the Therian knew no mercy, and it devoured its liberator. And it was then... It was then I obtained the power. The power to avenge my brother.
Velvet, you're a Therian?
What, we're just learning this now? We already knew that.
This prison island was a feeding ground for the Therian, harnessing the malevolence created by the prisoners within. But because Velvet escaped, the malevolence went out of control.
Wow, the same darn thing that happened back in Kamoana's village.
Oof.
Lord Artorias would never have done such a thing.
Yes, he would.
What's so unbelievable? That he used his wife's brother as a human sacrifice? That he imprisoned his wife's sister? Because that's what your damned holy shepherd did! All to get his hands on Inominat's power!
I'm sure he had a reason for...
A reason?! To spare the world of its pain! Don't give me that! Who will spare my brother's pain? Who will soothe my brother's despair?
Who will soothe mine?
You murdered my little brother, Luffy! And you'll stand there and tell me it was for the greater good? At any rate, that's one less Therian for us to track down.
What, we just knew that now? See, this is information we could have used earlier. Uh-oh, she's in danger.
Kamoana?
What? Did Velvet yell at you so hard you're starting to hear voices now?
I have a feeling something's wrong. Kamoana could be in danger.
All right, let's go help her.
But we already beat the Headless Knight.
I still can't shake this feeling. Please, let's go back and check on them.
Okay, sure. Oh, my expedition's back. Hold on while I check my expedition. I know the little girl's in danger, but, you know, it's not really that important. Or, I mean, yes, it most certainly is. Alright, let's get out of here. Oh, Velvet laying it on really heavy for Eleanor there, man. As you can see, Velvet has a lot of anger and resentment in her. I don't blame her, to be honest. Don's Lancer's situation with her sucks, man. And it turned her into a monster, too.
So, Velvet is a Therian, is she? I knew there was something off about
her. We already knew this information!
That's really on my mind. Luffy said, is Velvet truly Lord Artorias' younger sister?
She never told me.
If it were true, I suppose it would explain her knowledge of Lord Artorias' training.
If you're so curious, why not ask her yourself? Hey, Velvet, what's your connection to Artorias?
Rokuro, have some tact!
I heard you whispering. It doesn't bother me. Artorias was married to my late sister, Celica. He was our brother-in-law.
Celica from Fire Emblem!
We lived together for more than 10 years.
That does explain a few things.
So he sacrificed his little brother and turned his sister into a Therian.
But you were his family.
To his view of the grand scheme, family is inconsequential. The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few. All he did was act according to his ideal logic.
Wasted ideals.
Well, enough chit-chat. Let's get moving.
Yeah, Artorias is a bigger monster than we thought, huh? And he's gonna do the suppression, too. We're gonna learn more about that. And Artorias is going to turn out to be an even bigger monster than that. Isn't that wonderful? Our antagonists, everybody. See, this game is all sorts of sunshine and rainbows, isn't it? It's great. Yeah, I'm cutting myself so deep in all that rainbows. And, yeah. Alright, let's go save the little girl.
So it turns out that Velvet is a Therian who consumes malevolence. And too much malevolence is what changes people into demons. Strong enough malevolence can persist after the person who created it dies, turning their corpse or spirit into a raging monster. That's how undead and phantom demons come about.
Then the demons Velvet killed turned back into humans because she devoured their malevolence.
Yeah, and consequently, they avoided becoming undead or anything like that.
So she saved them. Well, I mean, a corpse is a corpse, of course, of course.
Do you think she could devour only the malevolence and turn a living demon human again?
Unfortunately, that's impossible due to malevolence's self-reinforcing nature. When Therians are connected to Enominot through an Earth Pulse point, they seem to be able to absorb small concentrations of malevolence from the surrounding area and inhibit the creation of new demons. But any human who builds up enough malevolence to turn into a demon will keep producing malevolence as long as they live.
That's right. To devour any malevolence, I need to cut it off at the source. That's how my powers work.
Velvet, I'm sorry.
I don't mind it. Actually, I find it convenient. This way, I'll never forget my hatred for Artorias.
Plus, as long as you stay away from an Earth Pulse point, you get to keep the power of any malevolence you consume.
Fuel for my hatred, yes.
Ow, the edge. See, the edge is so good in this game. Yeah. I cut myself so deep on that. It's like a razor blade with, where I cut myself shaving, right? Only it's like a double-sided razor, and it's sharper than, and it's sharper than a Krissy Kreme, and it strikes four times in one hit, yes. Because it's that edgy. And the edge is incredible. It gives you a really close shave, but it causes a lot of blood to spill. Because of course it does. What else would it do? Yes. That's how good the edge of this game is, man. And that's why I wanted to share it with everybody. So that you too can experience all the edge.
Ah, that was Kamoana.
Alright, let's see what's going on. Another Headless Knight. Good, more for Velvet to eat.
This must be the true survivor of the venomization process.
Oh, I get it! The dying exorcist lady wasn't saying Headless Knight is back. She was going for Headless Knight on horseback!
Whatever the case, we'll fight whoever we have to claim this island.
Alright, let's begin this fight. This one will be significantly harder than the last one, as I'm sure you're quite aware. Get him, Aizen. That didn't do quite as much damage as I hoped. Alright, we got stuns. Too bad stuns don't last forever. Let's see, armored undead fiends. I'm sure I have an art that deals with armored enemies. No. Maybe that'll work? Oh no, I got stunned, that's bad. I think that'll work, but no. It's doing a soul burst, that's bad.
Healing spell!
Alright, thank you for the heal. Watch out for that stun. Now it's hitting with really tough attacks. Come on, we can beat it. Well, he can still. But if we can stun it, we can lower its HP down. Now it's doing a soul burst. There we go. Knock it out.
That's venomization, all right. Definitely stronger than that headless lump of armor.
I beg your pardon?
Not you.
The head is up. Wait, what? A Therian?
Demon from the villa?
No, look! It's absorbing the malevolence. It's a Therian.
Actually, that hawk is Griffin. My one and only friend.
Wait, what?
A damned Therian. So that's what Tabitha meant when she said we'd find out shortly.
But Your Highness, why do you have a Therian?
It's like I said. Griffin has been my dear friend ever since I was a child. Even if he's a Therian now, that hasn't changed.
So you knew you were helping a Therian escape. What are you plotting?
I have no plots or schemes. I just want Griffin to be free.
I guess we shouldn't be surprised. The Crown Prince and future king, he's gonna do whatever he likes.
I suppose I am at that. But if I am, it's the first time I've ever been allowed a choice of my own.
Is your own
when
what?
You're a prince, you're not a person. You're an institution, one designed to serve the state and its people. Say, for instance, you're doing your law studies and your back suddenly itches. What do you do?
I mean, I'd scratch it. Who wouldn't?
When I did that, my tutor gave me a whipping so hard the blood ran down my back. The reason being that I prioritized a personal feeling, that is to say, my itch, over my studies in service of the state.
Multi.
Seeing Griffin lay claim to the skies let me imagine my own freedom. It was my lone solace over the years. But then, he turned out to be responsive to Innominat's power.
And Arthorius took him from you.
I take it the Midgand royal family is well aware that the Abbey is creating Therians.
Of course. How could we not? The kingdom offers unequivocal support to Shepherd Artorius's vision of reason and will. Even so, if there was one thing I could never permit, it was seeing Griffin locked up and unable to fly. Never. I tricked the exorcist on guard and disabled the barrier. But then Griffin attacked the exorcist and killed him.
That's why you said you could never go back.
They can overlook a single dead exorcist, but with a Therian removed, malevolence will engulf the capital.
Oh.
I knew full well what I was doing. And yet, I couldn't watch my friend's life be stripped away.
Highness.
He chose a single bird over the world. Why do you think that birds fly?
That's what Lord Artorius asked me.
My anatomy book says birds can fly because their bones are light and their wing muscles are enormously strong.
Birds fly because a bird that cannot fly is no bird at all. That's what I think.
Everyone has different answers to that question.
I understand now. As long as you remain on this island, you may do as you please. But if you try to escape, I'll kill you.
That should work. This way we'll have him on hand if we ever need a hostage.
Understood. I appreciate you letting Griffin and me stay here.
Oh, well, no problem, dude. Well,
now that that's taken care of, let's build ourselves a hideout.
Alright, I guess we claim the island now. Now we level up, cool.
Hey, Velvet, do you know where Eleanor is?
Wasn't she just playing with you?
Yeah, but then she left. I'm worried because she looked pretty sad.
Is it because of all the lore we dumped on her?
Find her?
Why me?
Alright, fine, I'll do it for you.
Alright, fine. Just don't cry on me, okay?
Alright, fine, I'll do it. Not like I have anything better to do. Well, she's not here. She's probably at the watchtower. Maybe. I might as well get all this stuff. And grab that. Just because I'm here. I think I know where she went for real. I'll just go visit her. She might be at the hole. Where Velvet was being kept in. Hey, Turtles. Don't become consumed with malevolence, Mr. Turtles. Otherwise, you're gonna become a tough super boss. That'll totally beat me up and stuff. Now, scrap that. And I'll head out. I can't believe I have to head all the way back down. That's okay. One's here. At least I think she's over here. It might be a different location. In which case, I'm probably wasting my time, but, you know, not a waste of time if I get to have fun. As you'll probably be aware. Nothing's ever a waste of time if you enjoyed yourself. Even if you have an off day, it's okay. She's not here. Not for sure she'd be here, but no. There are a few more places where she could be. Sorry, I don't really quite remember where she is. I apologize. I'll just have to search everywhere, then. Including at the cliffside, where she might be. Maybe over here? No, I don't think she's over here. I don't see a star in any way. I don't see a star saying that's where we need to go. This place is very dark and dreary. Music's kind of somber too. But what can you expect from this place? It is not a very nice place to be. Yeah, so Artorias turned out to be a real bad guy, yeah. As expected of her protagonist. And we're gonna choose a few over the needs of the world. After all, the world can rot. I wonder what's up here. Be a treasure of some sort? Oh, this is where I'm supposed to go. That outfit is silly. I like it. So many bright colors. In this otherwise edgy game.
Here you are, Eleanor. Kamoana's worried about you.
You actually came looking for me?
Can't say no to a crying child.
Indeed. She may be a Therian now, but deep down, she's still a lonely little girl. That's something I've come to realize in traveling with you all. Wretched demons and Therians, even the Malakim who I'd only thought of as tools, they all live and think as humanly as the rest of us. I was so clueless. I didn't know what demon blight really was, nor what the Abbey was doing. Through it all, I knew nothing beyond blind belief in whatever I was taught.
Ignorance is bliss, as they say.
The coward's path is not that of an exorcist. They may say, I didn't know anything, so I can't be blamed. I can't live like that.
Understood, Eleanor. That's okay. They were hiding all this information from all their top, from everyone else, aside from their elite.
I think I'll stay here a little longer to cool my head off. Please tell Kamoana I'm all right.
Fine, I guess I'll do that.
Don't stay out too long. The sea breeze can get cold.
Thank you.
Don't get the wrong idea. If you got sick or something, Kamoana and Lafayette would worry. That's all.
We have to hunt more Therians. Maybe the Bloodwings will know more. If we talk to them again, that is.
I have something to say. There's something I've been hiding, until now. I've been acting undercover on a special mission for Lord Artorias. I was to watch over the Malak Lafayette and bring him to Abbey headquarters. So vital was the mission, I was to do whatever it took, even kill my fellow exorcists.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
You were gonna take me to them.
I'm sorry for deceiving you, Lafayette. Originally, I was going to get you to lower your guard, then take you in. However, I no longer intend on following the Abbey's orders.
You're turning your back on Artorias?
He's a monster, why not?
No. I still believe in the sincerity of Lord Artorias. That the world he seeks is one that will benefit all humankind. But nevertheless, I simply cannot bring myself to condone the methods he has chosen to achieve that vision. So, I will help you protect the Therians until I discover the answer I seek.
Very well. What's that donut on your arm?
Eleanor!
I want to live a life that I don't have to be ashamed of. And to do that, I have to learn the truth for myself.
Understood.
So, you live by your emotions after all. Maybe you found your own creed.
Welcome to our wonderful world of wickedness.
Oh, yay.
Don't equate us. To act in opposition of one's feelings is to act opposed to reason.
You never make things simple, do you?
You should be glad I don't.
Very well.
Yeah. After all, she's my vessel.
Cool.
Yes, yes.
So, I think our next order of business is to find ourselves another Therian.
Let's go find him.
That's the extent of my insight. Anyone got any actual leads?
What if we had Eleanor swipe some intel on them from the Abbey? That could work.
I don't know.
It wouldn't work. Officially, the Abbey still considers her a traitor. So who would leak anything to her?
Yeah. Besides, we can't put Lafayette in danger like that. And anyway, Eleanor's terrible at being a spy.
Ungracious, but accurate.
You know that special underground cell from yesterday? I want to go back there. There's something I want to try out.
All right, let's go.
Okay, fine. I guess we'll go there.
Lafayette, I must offer you an apology.
What for?
For spying. I was plotting to take you back to the Abbey. I am truly sorry.
It was your mission, wasn't it? Somehow I think I always knew.
You did?
Call it a hunch. Besides, Velvet was really suspicious of you. Whenever you feel you're doing something wrong, you start to sweat a lot. It seemed odd.
How long have you known?
Ever since you became a vessel for me. I think Velvet knew too.
That's quite a shock. I failed completely in my role as a spy. It's pathetic. Shameful, really.
Well, I think it says something good about you.
Huh?
Someone who can't lie well seems like a better person than someone who has an easy time of it.
I agree.
Thank you, Lafayette. I think you're the better person here.
I wouldn't go that far. Hmm?
What are you doing here, Bianfu?
I was hoping you'd let me join in!
We're in the middle of something important. Please leave us be for now.
Agreed. Go away.
Be quiet. Just let me hang around, all right?
Afraid not.
Madam Eleanor is a mealy head!
She's a what?
Lafayette, thank you. I hope we can stay friends.
Oh.
I hope so too, Eleanor.
Oh. Oh, my expedition's back. I might as well do that. Yes, level 9.
This recipe looks real tasty.
Alright, and we learned to make something. Cool.
Scout ships.
Awesome, let's go get some more ingredients, huh? Alright, hope so. I most certainly like to go to that point. I think this is a good stopping point for right now. I thank you for watching and I hope you had plenty of fun. Remember to play games and have fun, okay? Bye-bye now. Oh, before we go, I want to do a raid. Let's see, who's on right now? I think Echo should be on. Let's do it. Raid. There we go. Just wait a little bit and then we'll be ready. Rather, I will. I'm the only one here. Hello. Alright, let's do it. Goodbye.